When I heard of Rube Goldberg, I thought it was just studying a man who invented stuff. But then I heard it was making stuff, and I was like, that sounds a lot like 4-H. And then when I saw the flag and stuff, I was like, oh, it is like 4-H.
It's a machine where you have to build a bunch of transfers of energy, and sometimes you have to start over.
A Rube Goldberg machine is a complex machine that does a simple task that's created using everyday objects in a creative and whimsical way to solve a challenge of the machine. And in 2017, the challenge is to raise a 4-H flag and wave it.
In programs like ours, you don't have a lot of resources to work with, and we're always looking for ways we can bring in programming and ways to incorporate what they're doing at school and make sure that they're not losing that information they've learned throughout the school year. So this is a great relationship for us to have because they bring in the professionals, they bring in the goal of the program, and we just run with it.
So the kids who are on the Rube Goldberg team, it's a group of young people, that are 3 to 10 of them, and they have completed grades 3 through 8. And those young people are learning to work together as a team in making decisions about designing the machine, gathering ideas.
There's a lot of communication involved. They have to problem solve throughout the entire thing every time they get together. So the communication and the problem solving is bigger than all the other pieces, I think.
I learned that a bunch of people can be leaders. Leadership means working together and not telling people what to do and bossing around.
What's really great about volunteers who work with Rube Goldberg is you don't have to be an engineer. Anyone that's willing to work with young people is who we would like to be a Rube Goldberg coach.
Organizations should take this on because they are supporting the future problem solvers, the future leaders, the future of all of these companies are these kids.